In this video, we're going to look at what is Docker, what does Docker do for us, and how do we get started working with Docker for our applications. Hi, I recently created a tutorial on deploying Java applications to Docker containers. Many of you asked that I create a series on Docker as well, so this video is the start of that series. Now, you've likely heard about Docker. It's one of those big buzzwords currently running through the IT industry. Docker is a Linux container technology that lets us package and ship our applications and everything it needs to execute into a standard format, and then run them on all of our existing Linux hardware. Now that might sound like a virtual machine, and it's a good start for how to think about Docker containers. Docker containers are similar to virtual machines in that our application runs on what seems to be its own hardware instance. Every Docker container has its own virtualized file system, memory, storage, CPU cycles, and so on. Where Docker containers differ is that they virtualize the operating system kernel, not the hardware. That means we can't run any operating system, we have to run Linux. However, we also don't need to install an operating system for every application we want to run. This makes our containers very lean. Virtual machines are much larger because we need to install the operating system, drivers, and so on for every virtual machine instance. We only focus on our application or what's different about a particular instance. Docker does this through a layered file system. Docker starts with a Linux kernel that all containers use. Then it layers the differences on top of the kernel. For example, the libraries for each distro here are layered on top of the Linux kernel. Then apps are layered on top of the distros. Even a command like echo hello world can be made into a container. Compare that to a virtual machine that often requires hundreds of megabytes, even gigabytes. Using a Docker container means we can run many more containers than virtual machines. It also means that we can set up larger environments on a single developer machine. The operating system might be gigabytes, but the differences between our Docker containers might be a few megabytes. This means we can have many instances all on one machine. The next thing we'd want to know is, how do we build a Docker container? How do we specify what applications are run in our container? A Docker container is described in a text file called a Dockerfile. Every Dockerfile has a unique name, usually the username, an identifier, and optionally a version identifier. The Dockerfile describes everything different in our container we need to run our application. The power of these files is they're like stackable bricks. We begin saying what we're starting with, and then we describe only what's different. For example, if we wanted to run a Java application, our Dockerfile might look like this. It says to start with Java 8 Dockerfile, and where to add our Java application, and specify how to run it. The Java 8 Dockerfile is another Dockerfile that builds Java onto a common configuration of Linux. And that is built using another Dockerfile that installs Debian. The beauty is, if we wanted to create another Dockerfile for, say, running Node, we can start with the same configured Linux Java uses. In these files, we're saying, give us everything up to this point, and we'll tell you what's different about our application. We can also run other commands like packages to install, environment variables to set, ports to expose, and so on. But everything unique about our Docker container is specified in the Dockerfile. Since this is a unique text file, we can give it to someone else and they can run exactly what we're running with the exact same environment. We don't have to worry about anything getting missed or another machine is configured differently. All the configuration is contained inside the container. This can easily scale to hundreds or thousands of instances of our container. It also means we can eliminate that "it runs on my machine" excuse. Packaging applications in Docker containers means the application should function the same locally as it would deployed in another environment. If we have a really cool Dockerfile, we can share it on Docker Hub. That's a repository of thousands of other Dockerfiles. These describe containers to run applications like Node, MySQL, Wildfly, or any other application we can think of. In fact, many of these Dockerfiles are official releases from the companies that create these tools. So if we want a Wildfly Docker container, we should start with the official Wildfly Dockerfile from Red Hat. Docker Hub is just one repository. We can use our own and even have private repositories. The best way to get started with Docker is to download and install the Docker Toolbox. The instructions for installing Docker Toolbox are very simple, so just pick your machine and install. This includes several tools, but the main tool is Docker Engine. Docker Engine is a workhorse for creating and running Docker containers. It's command line, but the commands are familiar if you know Linux. The steps for creating and using Docker containers are: write the Docker file, build the Docker container, and then run the Docker container. So let's try it out. We'll start by creating a simple Dockerfile that looks like this. We'll base our container on Ubuntu. We'll add one command that just echoes hello world. Next, we'll build the Dockerfile using this command in a command prompt, docker build. We'll run this command from the directory where our Dockerfile resides. When the container is built, Docker will say it successfully built a container, and it will call it a series of hex digits. So we'll tell Docker to run the container using the command docker run and that series of hex digits. The hex digits will be different on your machine, and when you run it, it should print hello world. We could give the container a better name, and we'll cover the Dockerfile in depth in the next video. Since it's a very small container, let's talk about what we just did. We created a file that described a Docker container. Inside the container, we asked Docker to add Ubuntu and then run the echo command. It runs a command which prints hello world. Since it has nothing else to do, the container terminates. What we didn't see, but we'll cover soon, is that this was all run in a Linux container, complete with its own file system, memory, and so on. The real power in Docker containers is that we can run any application, not just echo or any other Linux script commands. We're going to cover Docker in depth in the upcoming videos. This was just to explain what is Docker and how we use it. If you have any questions, add them to the comments below. If there are any specific Docker topics you'd like covered, let me know. And if you've enjoyed the video, please share the video with others. You'll want to sign up for the DGU newsletter. That's a monthly email containing the month's videos, plus tips and news not in these videos. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.